Consider a scenario where an e-commerce firm generates transactions in HTML format, but the style and layout are lost when viewed on different devices. Hence, the company wants to convert the HTML file to PDF. And since there is a batch of HTML files, an API would be helpful to batch convert these files and their content to PDF. Let's see how to convert HTML files to PDF using GCPDF. We will begin by creating a .NET Core console application in Visual Studio 2022, targeting the .NET 6 framework. Add the HTML file to be converted to PDF format to your project, and configure it for code access. Open the NuGet Package Manager using the Tools options from the menu bar. In the Manage NuGet Packages dialog, search for GrapeCity.documents.html package and install the package in your project. In the Solution Explorer, expand the dependencies and the packages folders to find the NuGet package installed in the project. Let's implement the first scenario, that is, saving the HTML file to PDF. Firstly, add the necessary namespaces to the project, including GrapeCity.documents.html, GrapeCity.documents.pdf, and system.drawing, which will be required for all conversion scenarios. Create an object of the GCPDF document class and add a new page to it. Fetch the page graphics by accessing the graphics property of the page class. Invoke the drawHTML method of the GCPDF graphics class, which reads the HTML content from the invoice.html file and draws at a specific position on the PDF graphics. The HTML to PDF format attribute will set the default values for rendering the HTML content with a default page size and background color. Save the document to PDF using the save method of the GCPDF document class. Run the application to convert the HTML file to a PDF document. Let's just quickly open and view the generated PDF file. Now let's consider you need to add an HTML string to a PDF. One of the reasons to do that is that you can add additional formatting to HTML content rather than with GCPDF. Let's see how to render an HTML string in your PDF file. Create a variable that holds the HTML content. Invoke the drawHTML method of the GCPDF graphics class, which renders the HTML string at a specific position on the PDF graphics. The HTML to PDF format attribute will set the default values for rendering the HTML content with a default page size and background color. You can set the max width of the page to the required size. You can draw a rounded rectangle around this string for visual effects using the drawRoundRect method of the GC Graphics class. Finally, save the document to PDF using the save method of the GCPDF document class. Run the application to render the HTML string on a PDF document. Let's just quickly open and view the generated PDF file. Lastly, Consider a scenario where you need to save certain pages to PDF for price comparison or distribute them as an information update to your employees. You can also render an entire web page to PDF using GC PDF API. Create a variable URI that holds the URI to the web page. Initialize an instance, passing the browser path into the constructor. Also create an instance of the PDF Options class that holds the settings for the generated PDF. Generate an HTML page, that is, an instance of the HTML page class, using the new page method of the GC HTML browser classes, which represents the web page to be converted to PDF. Call the Save as PDF method of the HTML page class and pass the PDF file and the PDF settings that will apply to the PDF file. Run the application and open the generated PDF file to observe how the entire web page is converted into PDF without loss of quality. This covers various scenarios of converting HTML to PDF. Interested in learning more? Head to grapecity.com/documents-api-pdf/documents-api-pdf-html.